Morning, my dear students of class 3. Welcome you back for the online sessions of your English classes. Children, hope you all are enjoying your English online classes and you are doing all your activities and completing all your textbooks and homeworks. So children, here I come with the lesson 4, which is yet another interesting lesson for you all. So before, just have a look with these pictures, children. What is this? It's a mice, right? Wait, what do you remember with this picture? Yes, a very favorite character of our cartoon. What is that? That is Jerry, yes. It's a very nice cartoon character, right? And also the Mickey Mouse and a Minnie Mouse, right? Yes, they are cute and adorable, right, children? So here, that is a story related to the mouse in a house. So the lesson name is House Mouse. So let us look into the lesson here. Before starting the lesson, let me just read out the new words for you all. Scrubbed, cleaned. Yield, cried out loudly in fright. Clothes line, rope or wire on which clothes can be hung or dried. Tickled, touched lightly. Ward, a room in a hospital, unexpected, not regarded as likely to happen. On cloud 9, that is very happy. So here is a story of a little mouse. Okay, so let us read out the story. Mrs. Melody had no children. No friends, no cat, no dog, no parrot. Mrs. Melody lived alone. When people said good morning to her, she scolded. When the postman brought her letters, she opened the door, the smallest crack to take them in and banged it shut again. So here Mrs. Melody was not at all a friendly woman. So in short, she doesn't have any pets, no dogs, no cats, nothing. She lived alone in her home. She was not friendly with anybody. When people used to wish her, she used to scold them. And when the postman brought the letters for her, she used to open the door a very little, take the letter and bang the door on the face. All day she cleaned her house, wiped the windows, polished the furniture and scrubbed the sink. Nobody ever came to see it. So what happens? Every time she is busy cleaning her house, she used to wipe her house, wipe the windows, polish the furniture, and also scrub her sink. So nobody used to come and meet her. She was all alone. And then what happened next? Underneath her sink, that is where we wash the vessels, right? There is a sink. Underneath the sink, there lived a little mouse. He was lonely too. He did no harm in the house. He didn't eat the cheese. He didn't make holes in the woodwork. He didn't leave dirty paw marks on the shelves. He found all his food out of the door in the lonely garden and only came indoor to get some company. So here lives a very calm mouse. He never used to disturb Mrs. Melody. Okay. He used to have his food outside only. He did not harm the house. He did not take the cheese from the house. Okay. He did not leave her his dirty paw marks. Like he did not run over the shelves and he did not ruin the house. Okay. So it was, he just came to the house only to have a company. But Mrs. Melody didn't like mice. When she caught the sight of him, she yelled as if a tiger had come into the kitchen. So what happened? She didn't, Miss Melody did not like the mice. So when she saw this mice under the sink, she screamed as if she had seen a tiger. This was enough to frighten the mouse away. But the mouse did not stay away for long because he was so lonely. So what happened? The mouse was frightened enough and he went off. But he could not stay back for a long time. He returned to Mrs. Melody's house. So he came back to Mrs. Melody and lived under the sink and tried to keep out of her way. So he came back to the house, but he was very careful that Mrs. Melody could not have a sight of him, could not see him. So if she sees again, she will scream and she will be scared, right? And he have to leave the house. So he was very careful about that. One day, Mrs. Melody spent the morning dusting everything in the house. Afterwards, she washed the duster and hung them out side by side to dry on the clothesline in the garden. Then she emptied out the soapy water, but dropped the soap. When she bent to pick it up, she slipped and fell on the kitchen floor. So what happened? She was continuing with her same routine. Okay, one day she was dusting everything in her house. Afterwards, she washed the dusters. Okay, the dusters mean the cloths which she used to dust. Okay, there were many clothes. And then she washed them and she hung outside in the garden to dry it off. Then afterwards, she emptied the soap water. What happened? But the soap dropped down. She put the soap down. And when she bent herself to pick the soap, she slipped and fell down on the kitchen floor. And then what happened? The mouse was scared to find Mrs. Melody lying on the floor with her eyes shut. He ran round and round her. He even tickled her chin with his sharp little nose. But nothing would wake her up. Now here, when she fell down, Mrs. Melody fell down, she is unconscious. Okay, she is just lying on the floor and the mouse is trying to help Melody, okay, to get her in consciousness. He's trying his best. He also tickled Mrs. Melody's chin with his sharp teeth, but she was not awakened. When Mrs. Melody did wake up, she found she could not move. So what happens? After some time, Mrs. Melody was conscious. When she woke up, she could find that she cannot move herself. She needs the medical help now. So what happens here next? Oh, little mouse, if only you were able to help me, she said. If you were a cat, you could fetch the neighbors. And if you were a dog, you could bark and howl until somebody come. If you were a parrot, you could shout, help, help. But don't think a mouse can do anything at all. Oh, but I really wish you could. Now, because Mrs. Melody is helpless, she is just telling the mouse, oh mouse, at least if you were a dog, you could have been barked and gathered the neighbors here. And if you were a cat, you could have been gone to neighbor's place and bring them here. And if you were a parrot, you could have been shouted for the help. But I can think that you will not be able to do anything of it. So I wish you could have been help me. Like this, Mrs. Melody is telling. Now the mouse is really very sad. So he's just thinking how to help Mrs. Melody. The mouse did not want to let her down. He ran out into the garden and looked around on the clothesline. So Mrs. Melody's duster was blowing in the wind. So what the mouse wants to really help Mrs. Melody. He went outside in the garden and he saw that there are the dusters which Melody has hung in the garden and they are just blowing in the wind. Okay. Then the mouse had a great idea. He ran up the post that held the line and began to nibble at the dusters. He bit till the first duster looked like a big H. Then he attached the next and nibbled it into an E. The third duster became an L and the last a P. So what a clever mouse is he. So what did the mouse did? He went up to the post and he started nibbling up the dusters until each duster looked like one alphabet. So first duster looked like H and second one he made it E and third he made L and the last one he made it as P. So altogether it makes one word. It is help, right? Help hung on the line, weaving in the wind. The mouse had proved smarter than a cat, a dog, or a parrot. So yes, so the mouse did a wonderful job. He has done the job which all these other animals cannot do, right? The next two neighbors saw it from her window. Something is wrong at Mrs. Melody, she shouted. In a minute, everybody was running to Mrs. Melody. The mouse went back underneath the sink. Soon the doctors arrived and then the ambulance. Mrs. Melody was taken to the hospital. So what happened? The next door neighbor could see that duster hanging on the line, the rope. So she could spell it and then she understood that Mrs. Melody is in a need of help. So all the neighbors rushed to Melody's house and they helped her. The doctors had arrived and the ambulance also had come. And they have taken Mrs. Melody to the hospital. Now let us see what happened next. Mrs. Melody had broken her leg. Everyone was kind to her and the neighbors brought her sweets and fruits and flowers. Mrs. Melody began to smile when she saw them coming and she also smiled at the nurse and the doctors and even at the other patients. She became quite a popular old lady in the ward. So now when she was admitted to the hospital, what happened? She started smiling over the people when she got to know that the neighbors are helping her and also bringing the fruits and the flowers to wish her. So she started smiling at everyone and she became a popular lady in the ward. Ward means in the hospital, the room where she was kept. What message? Asked Miss Melody. So here what happened? But what we can't understand is how you even hung the message on the clothesline when your leg was broken. The neighbor said, if we hadn't seen it, you might be lying there now. What message? Asked Mrs. Melody. So here, after some days passed, the neighbor was having a conversation with Mrs. Melody in the hospital. So when your leg was broken, how did you hang these help alphabets on the rope? So if we could have been not seen that letters, we could have been never come for your help. But Mrs. Melody is unaware, right? She doesn't know what was the message there. So Mrs. Melody is asking, what was the message there? They brought her the duster and laid them out on her bed. Help, she read. I believe it is my mouse, she said Mrs. Melody. Now the neighbor, she brought that letters, duster, and she put on the bed. So the letters spelled help, and then Mrs. Melody could guess that it was only the mouse who had helped her, and she said, it was my little mouse who helped me. They brought her. Then Mrs. Melody came home. People came visiting the house. Mrs. Melody introduced all of them to the mouse. He felt a little shy now. There was so much unexpected attention. But when the visitors had gone away, the only he and Mrs. Melody were sitting together in the kitchen. He crept out from under the sink. He was on cloud nine when he heard her telling him that he was the cleverest mouse in the world and she meant to keep the dusters forever to prove it. Now what happens afterwards when Melody told that the neighbors it was the clever mouse who had helped her, all the people came to see the mouse and then everybody were praising him. So now he was a little bit shy and he was very much happy. Okay, and all the attention what he was seeking was he was having a very nice experience. Now after all the visitors went back, now even Mrs. Melody is praising him. She's telling that you are the cleverest mouse I have seen and I will keep this duster for a long time to prove that you are a cleverest mouse in the world. So by this the story is done. We come to the end of a story. That means children, how your nature should be, you should be friendly, never be rude to any others. Okay, always be helpful, right children? Okay. So with this, we will end up the lesson and move on to our next answering session. Okay. So here we come to page number 58. Think and answer. The first one you will mark is option 2, cleaning her house. The second one is option 3, as he was lonely. And third one is option 2, nibbling the duster to form the message help. Okay. Now we will move on to the next page, that is page number 59. Taking the help of the words below, name each of the given animal's body part. The first one is mane. The second one is tusks. Third one is fins. Fourth one is paws. Fifth one is antenna. Sixth one is scales. Seventh one is hooves. And eighth one is shell. Move on to the page number 61. Complete the table of adjectives. Okay, here we have the degrees, positive, comparative and superlative degree. Okay, how we pronounce it? Bright, brighter, brightest. Warm, warmer, warmest. Heavy, heavier, heaviest. Poor, poorer, poorest. Dull, duller, dullest. Happy, happier, happiest. Young, younger, and youngest. So, second, we have some adjectives do not follow any of these rules. Can you complete the table? Yes, so here there are some changes. So little, less and least. Bad, worse and worst. Good, better, best. Beautiful, more beautiful and most beautiful. Interesting, more interesting and most interesting. So here page number 62, that is, in the given sentence the highlighted parts are idioms. Choose the correct meaning of each of these idioms. Okay, so here is, when this term won the T20 championship, Suresh was on top of the world. So, top of the world, okay. For that sentence, the same meaning is option C, that is feeling great. Second one is, time flies when I play badminton in the park. So, time flies, meaning of this the sentence, that is two words, is time goes by quickly. That is option B. Third one, hanging out. I was hanging out at the club with my friends. So, hanging out. The other word is spending time. That is option B. Page number 63. Fourth one, fed up. Option A, annoyed. The fifth one is, my neighbor and I promised to keep in touch even after she moved away to another city. The word is keep in touch. So, option B, be in contact. Okay, the last one. Now we will move on to the page number, that is 66. Positive, comparative and superlative. That is your worksheet for. Okay, clever, cleverer and cleverest. Noise, noisier, noisiest. Good, better, best. Narrow, narrower, narrowest. Modern, more modern and most modern. Old, older, oldest. Intelligent, more intelligent and most intelligent. The same it goes here, the positive, comparative and superlative in page number 67. The first one is done for you, that is poor, poorer and poorest. So the nice, What you will write? Nicer, nicest. Faithful, more faithful and most faithful. Strongest. Strong, stronger, strongest. Kind, kinder, kindest. Dark, darker, darkest. Young, younger and youngest. Bright, brighter and brightest. Frame sentence using these words, one has been done for you. So they have jumbled the words. You will have to form a proper sentence here. Okay. So the second one is, winter is colder than summer. Third one is, the ant is smaller than the mouse. Fourth one, January is the coldest month of the year. Fifth one, the tiger is more dangerous than the mouse. Then fifth one, the sun is hotter than the moon. Seventh one, England is closer than the sun. And the last one is, Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world. Okay, children. So this is it. All for the session. So keep in ready for your next assessment. Okay, children. So until our next session, do take care of yourself. Bye-bye for now.